Before we start training models in machine learning or computer vision, we usually visualize our data to get a better sense of what we are dealing with. If you are familiar with Python, you have heard or used packages like matplotlib or seaborn to visualize 2D images. But when it comes to visualizing 3D point cloud, we struggle a little bit. One of the main reasons for that is there are so many point cloud data formats out there we do not know much about. For example, there are point cloud file format or PLY, point cloud data, PCD, NumPy formats, NPY or NPZ, HDF5, which is short for hierarchical data format version 5, binary, laser formats, text, and many more. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the easy ways to visualize the most common point cloud file formats that we see in many popular point cloud datasets in computer vision like Toronto 3D, Trimble, Toyota PCD dataset, ScanNet, ShapeNet, SunRGB-D, Audi Autonomous Driving Dataset, ScanObjectNN, ModelNet-C, ShapeNet-C, KITTI, USGS, 3DEP, ModelNet-4D, Semantic-3D, and many more datasets. These datasets are used for all sorts of 3D point cloud tasks like point cloud classification, detection, segmentation, registration, shape completion, localization, and a lot more. Here I'm going to use two powerful Python packages for 3D point cloud visualization, Open3D and PPTK. Open3D is an open source library that can be used for 3D data structures, 3D data processing, scene reconstruction, surface alignment, and 3D visualization. And the other one is called the Point Processing Toolkit, commonly known as PPTK, which is a Python package for visualizing and processing 3D point clouds. Before we dive into the code, very quickly, what is a point cloud? A point cloud is basically a collection of individual points in 3D space. Each point is represented by its coordinate in XYZ plane. Sometimes additional data such as RGB values are available that determines the color of each point. That's enough about point cloud for this tutorial. Now let's check out the code. You can find this notebook in GitHub. Here is the instruction on how to install the required packages needed for this tutorial. One of the packages requires Python 3.6, so if you work with a newer version of Python and don't want to mess up anything on your computer, then you can create a Conda environment, which is totally optional. You just need the packages in the requirements file and this one installed. Also, the base lspy package cannot read .lsz file, so you need to use this command to install it with two backends. I have also provided the link to the data I'm using in this tutorial here. That's it, let's go back to the notebook. Just confirming that I'm using Python 3.6 for this tutorial. If you don't wish to use PPTK for this visualization, then you can work with a more recent version of Python. But I recommend PPTK, it's a good package for point cloud visualization. Then I load the required packages first. The first three packages are for reading and writing the files, and the Open3D and PPTK are for visualization. Then the first format here is PLY, short for Polygon File Format. Open3D input-output module has a function called readPointCloud that can read PLY files directly. We run this cell and the file is loaded. Easy peasy. PLY files can store a lot of different types of data. We are interested in two particular information: XYZ coordinates stored in points and RGB values stored in colors. Now let's check the basic details about the point cloud. Let's check how many points are there and if it has color information. So it has 196,000 points with XYZ coordinates, and each point has RGB values. Now let's do the visualization. Once you have an Open3D point cloud object, then you just have to call this function drawGeometries and use the point cloud as an input. Let's run this cell. We get this nice looking plot of this point cloud. You can now use the left button on your mouse and then drag to rotate. Then control left button and drag to translate, shift left button and drag to roll, and mouse wheel to zoom in and out. You can copy a particular view to the clipboard by pressing control C, and then you can change the view to see something else. And later on, if you want to see your saved view, then you just need to press control V. There are some other useful shortcuts available. For example, pressing L will switch between a phone lighting and a simple color rendering. Pressing 2 changes the color of the point cloud based on X coordinate. Pressing 3 changes to winter color map. Pressing 4 changes to hot color map. If you like a view and want to save it as a PNG file, then you can simply press P and save it. By pressing H, you can print help message and see an extensive list of shortcuts offered by Open3D. I guess that's the main things to know for visualization using Open3D. You can check out Open3D's website for more information on visualization and other 3D data processing methods. Now let's quickly go through the visualization of other file formats using Open3D. Now let's work on the PCD file format. We can read it the same way we just read the PLY file. Let's load the data and check the basic information. It has 1.4 million points, but it doesn't have any color information. That's why shape size is 0 here. Let's visualize it. It looks like a point cloud of a big area with trees and structures. Again, you can do all sorts of things I mentioned a minute ago, like change the colors, take screenshot, rotate, translate, zoom in and out and everything. Now what if you have a NumPy file or a text file or any other file that you know how to read in Python but don't know how to visualize? Then this portion is for you. So we have a NumPy n-dimensional array here. First we read the file. We have a 8192 by 3 size array. Now to visualize point cloud with Open3D, we need to define a point cloud class. Let's do it first. Then store the NumPy array to this class, specifically to the points property using vector3dvector function. That's it. Now it's same as before. We visualize it using drawGeometries function. It looks like a cylinder inside a rectangular box. Again, you can do rotation, translation, roll, zoom in and out, and everything else here. Let's move on to the next file format and use another one of my favorite Python visualization packages for point cloud called Point Processing Toolkit, PPTK. The LAS, short for Laser Format, is a file format created to store LiDAR point cloud data. It is an open source binary format data, which is widely used as an industry standard for LiDAR data. We can use LSPY package to read the file in Python. It's simply laspy.read and the file path as an argument. It looks like the file has 10,683 points in it. Let's see what we have in this file. We have XYZ coordinates of the point cloud and some other information like intensity, key points, and GPS time. Now for visualization, we need to create a NumPy array, taking the XYZ coordinates from the file and create an n by 3 size of array. Here n is 10,683. Now let's initiate the interactive visualization using PPTK package. It's simply PPTK.viewer. It's a point cloud of vegetation. These are trees or some types of plants. Now we can add a few optional properties to the visualization. For example, we can add color using the intensity values. You can change the background color, turn off the grids, hide the axis, change the color map to spring. Look, everything is applied here. If you want a red background, then change this to 1, it's red now. If you want a white background, then change this to 1 and 1. Now you have a white background. You also can capture the current view and save as a PNG file. In the same way, we can read and visualize LAZ file format. LAZ is a compressed LiDAR data format that typically comes in handy when you need to transfer or store large amounts of LiDAR data. We also can visualize this with PPTK package. This is supposed to be a point cloud of a plane, but it doesn't look like a plane to me. Anyways, H5 is hierarchical data format version 5. This is slightly different than what we have seen so far. So far, all of our file has only one point cloud stored in it. Although you can store more than one point cloud in NumPy formats, but in our example, it contained only one point cloud. This H5 file is a very small sample of ScanObjectNN dataset that contains only two point clouds. The actual ScanObjectNN training dataset has over 2000 point clouds. To read this file, we use file function from H5PY package. Here, points are stored in data property and labels are stored in label property. As you can see, two point clouds each has 2048 points and XYZ coordinates of each point, and two labels are stored in this file. Now we have NumPy arrays, so we simply use PPTK viewer to visualize the point cloud. Let's do the first one first. It's a chair. Okay, now the second one. It looks like a sink. I would say it's a sink. Let's close it. Now it's time for the binary file format. If you have used the famous KITTI point cloud dataset before, you know that it stores data in binary format. We are going to use NumPy to read the file and then reshape it. In this KITTI binary file, every point has four values, X, Y, Z, and intensity value. If you are wondering what does this intensity value mean, then intensity is a measure of the return strength of the laser pulse that generated the point. We have 19,669 points in the point cloud, and each point has four values. Finally, we visualize it with PPTK. That's it, very simple. This is a scene from KITTI data. You can see cars here on the road. Now it's the turn for the text file. I want to make a connection between PPTK and the Open3D package here with this example. Once you load the file in Python, you can use either of them to visualize as your preference. So we load the text file using np.loadText and delimiter comma. Now we have an array of size 10,000 by 6. That means each point has XYZ coordinates and RGB values. We can separate the XYZ coordinates and RGB values and store them in points and colors respectively. Then visualize using PPTK. It's a point cloud of a plane. We can do the same using Open3D. For that, we need to create a point cloud class first and store the points and colors in that object. Then use draw geometries to visualize. It's that easy. It's the same plane. I guess that's it. We have covered some of the most common point cloud file formats and learned how to visualize them in Python. I hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to comment. Thank you for watching. I will catch you in the next one.